Alright. Ooh, that got loud. I think we're good now. Another day, more puzzles. Let's go. I wonder if restore backup is their way of saying load game. Be pretty interesting. Wouldn't surprise me. Gregorian chant style music. Not really. But sounds like a chant. Yes. Actually, give myself a second. There are a lot of stars in this game. I'm gonna try something here. Go here, grab the keys, don't forget to go up the ladder. I think I've already gotten this one though, right? There are no keys here. Yeah, this didn't have keys. What? Oh, fuck. Well then. Seems that there is a ladder here somewhere. This isn't the one I was looking for though, was it? No. I was looking for a different star. This is the ladder they were talking about. find that goddamn cave. That's not the one I wanted, then. Cheating for now. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Okay, so they do track my star progress. Oh man. Well, we did 1 through 4 yesterday. Stars here. Boop, boop, boop. Ooh, it's raining. Oh god, this game is so gorgeous. Alright. Let's see. Just files this time, huh? Alright. EL, short for Extended Lifespan, is a groundbreaking initiative by 7 leading universities to create the world's most stable and most durable supercomputer. With its custom-made hardware, bomb-proof casing, and near-inexhaustible hydroelectric power supply, EL represents a unique step forward in the evolution of human technology. The brainchild of Nobel Prize nominee Dr. Arkady Chernyshev or something. Chernyshevsky. EL will... line break. Links, download press kit, meet the team, apply, and contact. Okay. AI citizenship, this should be interesting. Once a true artificial intelligence has been created, the issue of citizenship is going to come up. If we acknowledge that AI has all the abilities of a human brain, should it not be considered a citizen? Is it not, in the legal sense of the word, a person, and thus a potential citizen? But where do you draw the line? Some people will object. Will the great apes become citizens? Elephants? Whales? The more intelligent parrot species? It's crazy, they will say. I would remind these people that we live in a society in which a corporation, as abstract an entity as one could imagine, is considered a person. Ooh. Oh, shots fired. So it's not like there is a precedent for a non-human being a person. At least an artificial intelligence is an actual thinking being, not just a business arrangement. Perhaps we do not need to question the definition of personhood. Increasing amounts of evidence regarding the intelligence of elephants or the existence of culture among whales, for example, could be signs that we need to answer some difficult questions. Who better to debate these questions than with the young genius who revolutionized the corruption? You must consider these riddles, the Sphinx said, and tell me the riddle that I did not reveal. The Sphinx smiled, the gears in her jaw creaking, her teeth a nightmare of rust. Her left eye flickered, but none of its terror was diminished. The ruins were silent in the error. I think she finally said that the riddle you did not reveal is this. Why do these riddles exist in the first place? Why do these curious automatons, these mute children of Hephaestus, behave as they do, forcing me to devise these intricate solutions? Each is a riddle, but the greater riddle is their purpose. The Sphinx did not answer. Her eye was lifeless now. Athena removed it from its socket, knowing that its power would aid her, yet feeling also a deep sorrow at the passing of this fearful creature. Get right to it then. Puzzle time. Going over the fence. I'm gonna block. Okay, so I get to learn what this block is. It's a companion cube. It's a companion cube. Exploring a tiny bit. Alright, so basically that cube is necessary. The question is, where else can I... How far back can I move this? Because I need to be able to do something as simple as target that. Can I get this from maybe... I see. The door shall be opened. Oh, they label the puzzles. Okay. Alright. It stopped raining. Fascinating. We've got red. We've got a puzzle there that needs blue. We've got red here. That needs red to get the blue. And I have this little fella. Alright, well, for now, this will do. It's a lot easier. Buzzer. Alright, we have red. We have something that looks new. Because it is. I have a box. Red. Ooh, it's getting stormy again. Some of these puzzles are ridiculously easy compared to yesterday. Things to do with two boxes. Okay, so we have two boxes. Oh my god. Powerful device fashioned by the designer. What's a hexahedron? Okay. Cube. The edges are beveled, that makes it a decahedron. You forgot the indents. With the indents, it's like a super polyhedron. But the convex hull is a decahedron. Topic closed. Wrong. It's like the internet on a wall. Okay, give me my cube. Didn't think that would work. Gave it a shot anyway. This work? Didn't think so. Okay, kind of limiting the mechanics of the cubes here. So can I technically pick this one up? Didn't think so. Okay. What if I did something like that? Move it. So maybe. Okay. Need that cube though. Designer is perfect and he designed for purpose. I must be fit for that purpose. It follows that my purpose must not be to seek and hoard every sigil in his land, for so many are beyond the faculties he granted me. I do not understand why the designer chose to put such flaws into the world that it appears almost as if it were damaged, but I must believe that there is a purpose here I cannot see. Water levels or rain levels are depressing as fuck.
Here, those who are worthy may seek the counsel of my blessed messengers. But their wisdom shall not be given easily, for your accomplishments must be your own.
Guess it's help on how to solve a problem. It's bleak and dreary with this music on top of it. Oh. So I kind of have an idea of what to do. I need to get that one to blow up that thing, and then I can kind of jam things differently. Maybe the solution is actually this. So I just noticed that guy bouncing around. Yup. I can do that, and I can do that. That may be enough. A lot easier than I was expecting.
was in school when I first read about the Talos Principle. I think it disturbed me at the time, made me hyper-aware of my body as a physical object, the material reality of the brain. Ideas that made me uncomfortable at first, but I think in the long run, help me understand how frail human beings are and how precious. It's not a comforting way of thinking about the world, but I'd rather face the truth than lie to myself.
Ooh, lots of red here. That'll be an interesting series.
Long ago, I shaped these lands according to the purpose of the hidden words. Thus, all things have meaning where before was only chaos. Know that and have faith.
You've received a reply to your user support ticket. Account certification program diagnostic has been performed and no errors are reported. Have you completed the standard troubleshooting procedures? Delete existing user account, create a new admin account, email the network administrator. In order to prevent unauthorized access, the admin controls only persons in the... no registered account, but certification data already exists. Would you like to undertake the certification process again to achieve a preferable outcome? Yes. Your issues with denial will be appended to your user profile. Further attempts to override certification results will be logged. You will receive a notification if your attention is required. I didn't get the mail. LOL.email. Ever since we moved to the new site, I feel funny. No, not in that way, just I feel like I'm about to start laughing at random. It's probably shock, right? An inability to deal with reality? Or maybe it's just that we're working in this insane project with this insane technology on this insane... We're working in this insane place, sorry, with this insane technology on this insane project, and so I feel like a genuine mad scientist. Stand aside, mortals, we will create life by the power of science! I mentioned this to Alex and she got me a pair of fake glasses. You can't be a mad scientist without glasses, she said. Even Ian Malcolm had glasses. And I pointed at EL and said, life finds a way. Maybe you had to be there. Any emails sent from this address are to be considered confidential. Sharing or forwarding without permission may result in prosecution by the enraged spirit of Jeff Goldblum. Sure. Cicero. Shall the industrious husbandman then plant trees, the fruit of which he shall never see? And shall not the great man found laws, institutions in a republic? What does the procreation of children imply, and our care to continue our names, and our adoptions, and our scrupulous exactness in drawing of wills, and the inscriptions on monuments, and panegyrics, but that our thoughts run on futurity? What do you imagine... that so many and such great men of our republic who have sacrificed their lives thought that their name should not continue... sacrificed their lives for its good expected. Do you believe that they thought their names should not continue being in their lives? None ever encountered death for their country, but under a firm persuasion of immortality. Themistocles might have lived at his ease, so might Epaminondas... and not to look abroad and among the ancients, for instance, so might I myself. But somehow or other, there clings to our minds a certain presage of future ages, and this both exists most firmly and appears most clearly in men of the loftiest genius and greatest souls. Take away this, and who would be so mad as to spend his life amidst toils and dangers? Chatbots. Chatbots are becoming increasingly sophisticated, true, but hardly relevant to this discussion. Are you sure? How do you know that I'm not a bot? Don't be ridiculous. I'm not ridiculous. Honestly, how would you know? Haha, troll. I'm not a troll. Yeah, right. Is there anything I've written so far that could not be written by a bot? I responded to simple insults like ridiculous and troll with very basic negations, and I detected that none of you use proper orthography, so I also avoided capitalization. What's the capital of France? Paris. Even the simplest script can pull that info from the net. What's the capital of Croatia? Zagreb. Okay, she's a bot. I'm not a bot, I'm European. We learn these things in school. I've seen you in this chat room many times. Bots can't participate in discussions. At least they can interject random comments. Sam is right. Stop trolling. Vegan warrior. Sam is a bot. Vegan warrior is probably the bot. At best, they can interject random comments. Yeah. All right. So keys. Those are keys. Mobile bind field. Must serve a purpose. Boo boo. So many beeps and boops. Simple principle. Though Stratton himself never used the term, his remark that the inescapable materiality of life, that like the bronze giant Talos, even the most faithful philosopher cannot live without his blood, ultimately became known as the Talos Principle. What seemingly enraged many of his contemporaries and a significant number of later thinkers is that the principle's simplicity and unassailability, which, according to a fragment found in Miletus, cut through their rhetorical webs, which sought to tangle the listener with fanciful words and thoughts of the heavens, like Alexander's sword with the guardian knot. Diogenes Laertius makes mention of a dialogue by Anaximander of Chalcedon that expanded greatly on the Talos principle, but that work remains lost. Arcady Journal. Officially began work on archive today. Contributors from every country on Earth, while network connections last. Team intimidated by Project Scope but working hard. We'll be sharing space with Drennan and Serapi team. Look forward to meeting them. 12 comments. First, oh god. Seriously, cheese fan, that was the best you could say. LOL. A great snapshot of the human species at its best and at its worst. At its worst, come on. It's just a comment. I'm not Stalin. Stalin was also a troll commenter. Maybe you should cut out the jokes. Serious, most serious thing that's ever happened. I think that's a great reason to joke around. Internet's working less and less. Goodbye, all. Bye. God bless you. Last. Wow. Okay.